Music played a huge part in growing up in my house in Dublin. My father was he came from a very rural part of Ireland, a place called Rathlin Island on the north coast of Antrim. And he was very passionate about more traditional music. My mother, on the other hand, came from the heart of Dublin, and was as passionate in her own way about music, but a different style of music, the music of the day. And so between them, they handed down this great great love of music, and there would always be instruments in the house. There would always be friends invited back maybe on a Sunday afternoon, and singing and music was a big, big part of growing up in my life, yeah. I wasn't a purist in the same way as if I came from the west of Ireland and was brought up in that tradition. So there was that different, and then of course I was listening a lot as growing up to what was popular in the radio as well, and I was a big Beatles fan, and I was listening to you know, country music when I got into my teens, and you know, folk music probably more so, but generally I had a broader interest in music, you know. I have a house which is down in West Kerry, southwest of Ireland, and in that small community is primarily Irish-speaking area, steeped in tradition, the most beautiful, glorious landscape, which I feel reflects the music, because the music is very beautiful as well. And it's very much, the traditional music is very much alive. The songs, the dance, everything. And it's so important for me to feel that I can still be in that small group, walk into a little bar with maybe a half a dozen to a dozen people sitting around and exchange songs and stories in that way. And I think that's something that'll stay with me till I die. For me, that's what it's all about. There are, of course, differences. It's funny because there are so many Irish Americans and Irish Australians, and the kernel of the people is the same. There's that longing for the tradition, or that ancestry, to sort of have a meaning, or to sort of connect. And I see similarities in that way. I see lots of differences in other ways, in personality. You know, the personality of it's very difficult to sort of break it down. But I know when I come to Australia, I actually feel more at home than I do in America. As an Irish person, I feel a connection, stronger connection to Australia than I do to America. Even though they're probably much more American Irish than there are Australian Irish, when you think in terms of numbers. I think the most significant connection for me with Australia from a musical point of view was meeting up with Shane Howard. And I'm just such a great fan of Shane's, you know. I think he's an amazing artist, an amazing writer. Keeping all that fear inside. The thing that was most striking was his songs for me. Being a singer of other people's songs primarily, I'm always, it's like I have a little keen ear there all the time for a good song. Oh, there's a thousand things to do. Let's start with me and you. I take a little time. Let's see what we can find. Oh, come on, walk with me. Talk with me, tell me your stories. I'll do my best to understand you.
I remember being in Ireland in about 1998 with Steve Cooney, and we're in the kitchen with Father O'Riordan. At about 4 a.m, he said to me, "How far do your feet go down?" And I went, "Pardon?" He said, "How far do your feet go down into the earth?" And in Ireland, I wasn't sure about that. And it took me a moment to process, and I thought, ancestrally, my feet go right down into the earth there. And here, we're only getting our feet into the earth. And, you know, my people were all, they landed here from Ireland in Killarney, our families. And I roamed that country as a kid over the back beach. There always seemed to be something missing, and I guess as I got older and became aware of the Aboriginal history of the country, it was that Aboriginal presence that I became, this deep 40,000 year history that I became more and more aware of. I talk about Port Fairy, this festival being my spiritual home. It is for family reasons. I guess the first album that Goanna did was called Spirit of Place, which was a phrase that Manning Clark used in his History of Australia. The Latin phrase, which I think goes back to Tacitus, is actually genius loci, the genius of the place or the spirit of the place. And I guess Manning Clark had this vision that inevitably the land, the climate, determines who you become. And I guess as white fellas here in Australia, we're in this process of culturally off-becoming, and of belonging. And a lot of my work, I guess, deals with trying to find a path to belonging, a way to belong here. It's a deeply Aboriginal country, and it's a deeply spiritual country for those reasons. Solid Rock and Goanna and Spirit of Place threw me headfirst into Aboriginal Australia, and that great sense of awakening, I guess, about the spirit that is in the land. And I'm not the first white fella to come across that notion. It's there in all the old early Australian bush songs and stuff too, this becoming into the land and the love of the land. And so I guess that's probably for me is that spiritual notion. It's a great, we're in a different part of the world here. It's green and it's dairy cattle and it's a fertile little neck of the woods. But Australia itself is a big dry place. It's a place of big flat plains and a place of long distances and big thoughts. Mm. You can think big thoughts in a big landscape. And I guess, so in that sense, it's a very spiritual landscape.
So we hooked up with Shane in 96 to do Saltwater Country. And then came down to Melbourne, did a few of the Goanna Spirit Returns concert, and then we got to meet Karen, and it sort of circle spread, I guess.
Shane is a big instigator, and the people we have met, and the musicians we have met, he's like a connector of music and spirit, kind of thing, and I admire him highly for that, because that is what he's doing. He actually joins song lines together, etc. It's very much a part of his thing, which he realizes that's parts of us is probably similar, and I guess we have this connection with all the land stuff that our whole lifestyle's built around getting our own food. While we balance, it's a balancing act, obviously. We live in a modern world as well, so with the music, it's been probably the thing that's kept us together in a sense. Old man built me a guitar when I was about 3, so that's my first recollections of music in the family, and he's always sung, and then there's uncles that from my mother's side that we're always singing and parties and playing ukuleles, and so again that we were shaped by circumstance and isolation, mainly through ABC Radio Australia, listening to shortwave station, picking up Indonesian stations and New Guinea stations, and
everyone asked you what sort of music you play, so in the end we had this idea for a title for the first album, which was Saltwater Country. So it's that sort of bend on country music, because we sing about our country, so I guess,
So, really that's where it all stems from, I guess. It's that's what we do. We just play under the tree, under a mango tree, on the veranda. We play in the dirt. It's that kind of vibe that he was after. It's a party atmosphere, yet you're playing with a bit of zing.
Currently, there's 7 brothers in the band, and the songwriting is shared between all of us. The third album's out now, and on that one, Colin's actually got about 6 songs that he brought to the band, and we've developed them. And prior to that, I'd done a fair bit of it. Dave's always chucked in a couple, so I guess there's 3 of us that are the main songwriters. It's usually a melody, a set of chords, and the lyrics. Sometimes some lyrics are written 5 minutes before the main vocal track is done in the studio. But by then, I've got the gist of the song. So it's a melody first for me, the melody inspires the pictures, and the pictures inspires the words.
This is a homesick song.
I feel like going back home right now while the mangoes are ripe. Friend, your panties starting to bloom and them blue bones starting to bite. Hey mum, I can just taste your fish soup and rice. I'm coming back home to you. Can't hack the pace of the city life, soon I'll be dreaming in blue. We're heading out to Blackberry Tree now. We got the dust and mud stuck in our hair. Larry, Larry, there's the Obia. Honey, Phil, well, she really don't care. Yeah, Mum, I can just taste your fish soup and rice. I'm coming back home to you. Can't act the pace of the city life, soon we'll be dreaming in blue. Lazy breeze blowing through your mind. Sky blue sea, catch your feet there anytime. Luggers are in on the springtime. Hey, the gambling house is packed. The banker he'll muck on, we'll sit on. But lovey, we got both up in front. And dad, we're gonna rag a little sippy tonight. Make a riot and sing with the moon. Of the city life, soon to be dreaming in blue. Yeah, I feel like going back home right now while the garbage is ripe. The jiggle tree's starting to bloom and them gear is starting to bite. Yeah, Mum, I can just taste your fish soup and rice. I'm coming back home to you. Caught at the pace of the city life, soon to be dreaming in blue. Soon to be dreaming.